All right, good day everyone. My name is Mr. Omar Godwin, and today we'll be looking at our mathematics simple ideas of algebra. Yeah, I want to consider some rudiments in algebra equation as it relates to our maths. Now, in mathematics, we use numbers sentences as well as algebraic sentence. We will consider the following sentences. We want to check what algebra is in this one. So a mathematical sentence with numbers or an operation symbol, a variable, all these are all called algebraic equation. So in a short while, we'll be looking at algebraic equation, what they mean and what they are, number sentence if you so wish. Now this is 12, yeah, 12 plus 8, that's equal 20, 15 minus 3, that will give us 12. Now these, all these two here, they're what we call number sentence in maths. They are number sentences. Okay, now we move forward. Now this here, we have a letter and a number, letter and a number. So we have x plus 8 equals 20, and we also have a 9 minus y equals 3. Now this is one, this one is different from like your number sentence. This is a mathematical statement. Yes, it's a mathematical sentence which involve letters and number, and so we call it algebraic sentence. Now, the ones that have letters and number, they are called what? Algebraic sentence. The one with no letters, just numbers, we call them number sentences. I hope you grab it, get it. So when you say something like 9 plus 3 equals, that's a 12, this one is not, this is what? This is just a number sentence. Why these guys here, they are algebraic sentences. So let's get into it. Algebraic sentence can either be true or false. Every time you see in maths, where you see something on the left and something on the right, it's telling you that we have two ends. And in equation, we usually have two ends. It can either be true or false. Now they told us 12 plus 8, will it give me 20? Of course, that is true. So in your quest to solving algebra, you have to check if it is true or false. Now, 15 minus 3, will it give me 12? Yes, these are true sentences because both sides are equal. What do we mean by both sides? We said 12 plus 8 is equal to 20. How true is this? What is 12 plus 8? That is 20. So 20 is equal to 20. That is what we mean. Is that clear? All right, so when both ends in this algebraic equation or sentences is true, we can ascertain if the values are the same. That's why we say we have a right and we have a left, we'll verify them. Okay, now these are just numbers. We also have it here. 17 plus 7, will that give us 23? Nope, so that is wrong. 15 minus 10, will it give you 9? Nope, that's wrong. These ones are false sentences since both sides are not equal. How do you know, Mr. Moore? This is how we know. So let's look at it. 17 plus 7. Yep. 4. Mm-hmm. So you know 7 plus 7 is 14, 4 and 1. Then we have 24. Is that not so? All right. Then, is 24 equal to 23? No. You can see it is not equal to each other, so it is false. Now, the other one we check, 15 minus 10, it said is equal to 9. Is that correct? It is not equal to 9. 15 minus 10 is going to give us what? A resounding 5 as an answer. So when the statements are not true, we know that they are not equal. Also, an algebra sentence can either be false or true depending on the value of the unknown. For example, we have 12 plus x is equal to 20. This is only true when what? When we check and we find out the value of x. Now, it is true when 8 is put in the place of x. How do we do that? We know it was 12 plus x is equal to what now? Equal to 20. If it's only true if x is equal to 8. And let's see, if my x is 8, that makes it 12 plus, in the place of x, I'll put 8. 12 plus 8, that will give me what, boys and girls? 20. Yeah. So you have to check. And how we check is by solving. We'll solve. because math is fun, you know. You solve and get the answer. So in summary, any true number or algebraic sentence is called an equation. An equation shows equality between two numbers or quantities, and it is always expressed by the sign equal to. So this sign is very important. When you say something is equal to the left hand side and the right hand side, it means what you are saying is these things are the same. 3 plus 2 equals 5. What you are saying is that 5 is also the same thing as 5. That is what it means. All right, so let's go. So find the value of the unknown, which makes an equation true, means we have to solve that equation. Already said, so simple equation that we want to check by subtracting or adding. Let's quickly put our hands on this. I love this math. So example, we have one to solve here. X plus 11 equals 30. Now you can see here, this is what kind of equation is it? Because it's having letters and number. So it's an algebraic equation. Now, because we have x plus 6, we want to make x stand alone. Because we are looking for x, we don't know what number will you add to x that will give you 30. That's the question they are asking you. So I'm going to subtract, like it says, they subtract 11 from both sides. This is my left, remember, this is my right. And in algebraic equation, whatever you do to the left, you do to the right. So we will have x plus 11 minus 11 equals 30 minus 11. Why did I use minus 11? I'll tell you. If I want 11 to go out of this place, because I need only x to remain here, and because this is a plus here, I know I have to say, okay, plus 11 minus 11. That will give me 0. So I have only x standing here. So x is equal to, what is 11 minus, 30 minus 11? That will give me 19. So this becomes my answer. Isn't it beautiful? Let's see one more example. When we have subtraction, we have x minus 12 equals 8. They're asking you, what is the value of x? So that when you subtract 12, it will give you 8. It's going to be easy peasy, trust me. So when I have minus c, what I have to do is I'm going to add 12 to both sides. X plus, x minus 12 plus 12 equals 8 plus 12. And guess what? X is now alone because 12 minus 12 plus 12 cancel itself out. X plus 12, that will give me 20. Should we check if my x is 20 now? X is 20. If we say 20 minus 12, what would that give me, boys and girls? It will give me 8. So we are correct. Yippee! Yay! So you see, this is an algebraic equation. You'll be expecting more from our follow-up questions. And there's a little evaluation for you. An equation has how many sides? Can you tell me that? Zeus, just a giveaway. Come on. An equation has how many sides? Beautiful. So an equation is true if what happens? Brilliant. Thank you so much for listening. I know you have a wonderful time because I did and you've learned. So wait for our follow-up questions during the week. Thank you and bye-bye. My name is Mr. Godwin.